So please look at this image here. This is the inferior vena cava, and you are seeing these vessels which are coming converging towards the inferior vena cava. These are your hepatic veins. These are how the hepatic veins will appear, right? They converge onto the inferior vena cava. Whereas the portal vein, they travel transversely in the liver. So look at this image again. You can see between the right and the left crest of diaphragm, between the crura of the diaphragm, you have the aorta. And to the right of the aorta, this is the right side, this is the left side, guys. So towards the right of the aorta, we have the inferior vena cava. So this is the inferior vena cava to the right of the aorta. And you can see this is the area of the portal vein. This is the splenic artery. This is probably a part of the celiac trunk that is shown. And this is your hepatic artery. So the hepatic artery, the splenic artery, are coming from the celiac trunk that are seen. So aorta, inferior vena cava, portal vein, and just anterior to the portal vein, you see this small vessel. This is your hepatic artery. So you should know how to check for the hepatic veins. The hepatic veins, they run longitudinally in the liver and they try to converge towards the inferior vena cava. Portal vein, they go transversely in the liver. And the hepatic artery is a structure that is present just anterior to the portal vein. And the enhancement pattern also. So whenever the aorta is getting enhanced, these hepatic arteries will be enhancing. And in the portal venous phase, obviously the portal structures will be seen more better. Now, let's try to understand the vessels in this image also. Try to look at the image carefully. I hope you can identify this is the aorta. And this structure here is the inferior vena cava. And just from the aorta going towards the right kidney, if you trace this carefully, this vessel that is coming from the aorta tracing towards the right kidney, this is your right renal artery. And from the inferior vena cava, this vein which is coming towards the left kidney here, this would be left renal vein. So you should be able to tell which is the renal artery, which is the renal vein, by looking and tracing them back to the aorta or back to the inferior vena cava. So the aorta and the right renal artery is shown here, and the inferior vena cava and the left renal vein is shown here by looking at their drainage into these respective vessels. And also, please understand this vessel here, okay, which is a branch of the aorta, okay, which has gone in front of the left renal vein. This is your superior mesenteric artery, superior mesenteric artery. And towards the right of the superior mesenteric artery, this structure is your superior mesenteric vein. So superior mesenteric vein will always lie to the right of superior mesenteric artery, to the right of superior mesenteric artery. And this superior mesenteric artery will be joining this splenic vein. You can see this vein here coming. This is the splenic vein. And both of this confluence will then form the portal vein that we saw, right? So the splenic vein joins with the superior mesenteric vein to form the portal vein. The splenic artery will pass anterior to the left renal vein. And the orientation of superior mesenteric artery and the superior mesenteric vein should be understood. Superior mesenteric artery normally lies to the left of the superior mesenteric vein if there is a malrotation of the gut, right? If there is midgut volvulus or malrotation, you may have this vessels changing their position. The superior mesenteric artery may come to the right and the superior mesenteric vein may go to the left in cases of malrotation.